adherents to magic believe that it may work by one or more of the following basic principles. Natural forces that cannot be detected by science at present and, in fact, may not be detectable at all. These magical forces are said to exist in addition to and alongside the four fundamental forces of nature: gravity, electromagnetism, the strong force, and the weak force. Intervention of spirits similar to these hypothetical natural forces, but with their own consciousness and intelligence. Believers in spirits will often describe a whole cosmos of beings of many different kinds, sometimes organized into a hierarchy. A mystical power, such as mana, chi, or nimin, that exists in all things. Sometimes, this power is contained in a magical object, such as a ring, a stone, charm, or deck, which the magician can manipulate. Manipulation of the elements by using the will of the magician and or with symbols or objects representative of the element S. Western practitioners typically use the classical elements of earth, air, water, and fire. Manipulation of energy, also believed to be the manipulation of energy from the human body, most commonly referred to by the usage of the hands, while the mouth uses a command of power. Manipulation of symbols. Adherents of magical thinking believe that symbols can be used for more than representation. They can magically take on a physical quality of the phenomenon or object that they represent. By manipulating symbols as well as sigils, one is said to be able to manipulate the reality that this symbol represents. The principles of sympathetic magic of Sir James George Frazer explicated in his The Golden Bough. These principles include the law of similarity and the law of contact, or contagion. These are systematized versions of the manipulation of symbols. Frazer defined them this way: if we analyze the principles of thought on which magic is based, they will probably be found to resolve themselves into two. First, that like produces like, or that an effect resembles its cause. And second, that things which have once been in contact with each other continue to act on each other at a distance after the physical contact has been severed. The former principle may be called the law of similarity, the latter the law of contact or contagion. From the first of these principles, namely the law of similarity, the magician infers that he can produce any effect he desires merely by imitating it. From the second, he infers that whatever he does to a material object will affect equally the person with whom the object was once in contact, whether it formed part of his body or not. Concentration or meditation, a certain amount of focusing or restricting the mind to some imagined object or will, according to Aleister Crowley, produces mystical attainment or an occurrence in the brain characterized essentially by the uniting of subject and object. Magic, as defined previously, seeks to ape concentration by constantly recalling the attention to the chosen object or will, thereby producing said attainment. For example, if one wishes to concentrate on a god, one might memorize a system of correspondences, perhaps chosen arbitrarily, as this would not affect its usefulness for mystical purposes, and then make every object that one sees correspond to said god, the magical power of the subconscious mind. To believers who think they need to convince their subconscious mind to make the changes they want, all spirits and energies are projections and symbols that make sense to the subconscious. A variant of this belief is that the subconscious is capable of contacting spirits, who in turn can work magic. A mysterious interconnection in the cosmos that connects and binds all things above and beyond the natural forces, or in some cases thought to be an as yet undiscovered or unquantifiable natural force. The oneness in all, based on the fundamental concepts of monism and non-duality, this philosophy holds that magic is little more than the application of one's own inherent unity with the universe. Key principles of utilizing magic are often said to be concentration and visualization. Many of those who cast spells attain a mental state called the trance state to enable the spell. The trance state is often described as an emptying of the mind akin to meditation.